Yo, 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 we back over here at Hip Hop Originals, man. Hey, you already know, hey, right now I'm sitting in front of, you know what I'm saying, the legendary West Coast hip hop group, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I want y'all to give it up for the Dove Shack.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Welcome to Hip Hop Originals, man. How y'all doing?
What's up? Oh,
yeah.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, yeah, and thanks for stopping by, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man, yeah. How y'all enjoying today, you know what I'm saying, the vibes and everything out here?
It's a beautiful vibe right now, Definitely. It's a beautiful vibe right now. Everybody feeling good in this California sunshine.
Right, yeah.
Yes, sir. Summertime.
Summertime.
Yeah. LBC. Summertime all over the world, though, you know?
Right. Yeah.
Y'all performing?
Yeah. I think we're going about 8 o'clock.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
We got some classics for y'all and some new shit for y'all, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, definitely, though, you know. Like, definitely, you know what I'm saying, real quick, like, give us, like, the origins of, like, y'all, like, how y'all got started back in the day.
Yeah.
Well, I invented the whole thing. My name is Two Scoop.
Whatever.
Okay. we used to hang out at C-Night spot. His grandmother gave him the garage to do what he wanted to do. The name Garage is born, so we called it a shack. And that's where we developed our style and our, you know, our image and shit. And we just took it from there and ran with it.
What you youngsters like to call it, our swagger?
Yeah. We made our swag right there in the shack.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Like, you know what I'm saying, like, inspired y'all to, like, start y'all group and everything, like, back then?
We weren't really even trying to make a group or nothing. Just something we used to like to do, me and Two Scoop.
Okay.
You know, it started with me and Scoop, you know what I'm saying? And we just like to, you know, we just used to like to rap after the football game, playing football.
You said Snoop?
I mean,
Scoop. Two Scoop.
Yeah, but Snoop was our childhood friend.
Wow. And watching we grew him, up with Snoop,
and watching
Warren
him,
G,
like, you know, blow.
Nate Dogg.
Did put
shout
a spark
Dogg,
up under us and let us know that if this nigga can do it, we can do it, like, type of energy, right. Like, you know what I'm saying? I introduced Snoop to his wife. We go way back before the music.
Wow.
And, I would have to say, like, he did a lot as far as letting us know that we, one of us did it, two of us can do it, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right. I know y'all mentioned that at first it was just for fun. What made you think?
That's what I'm saying, like Snoop and not just Snoop, but I'm saying, like,
I think we got more serious when Warren took us to the studio.
Warren,
yeah.
I think that was the
I think
life
our non-serious was still serious enough to make some noise, because we had, like, a local buzz in Long Beach that was, like, pushing us. No matter, like, we was in a couple of weeks before we was the Dove Shack, changed the name from this to that, and we had talent shows and shit like that, or whatever, you know, paying the dues part.
Yeah.
And we was getting a good reception, so I mean. When we was not taking it serious, it was still somewhat serious, you know what I'm saying? Wow. Warren G just made it official.
Wow, okay.
Yeah. We went pro league. From amateur to pro league. We was on that regulator.
We've been pros for about 28 years now.
Wow. Yeah. Hey, that's how old I am, 28. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
You were still in daddy nuts when we went professional.
Yeah. Yeah, the first album we ever appeared on in our life went for four platinum, like, in under a year. So,
okay.
So we had a good little
shout out to Warren G.
Yeah, we had a good little shove start right there. You know what I mean?
G Funk era.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Like, how many was it y'all originally in the group?
It's three of us, and it's still three. Well, actually, it's six of us.
Okay.
Rest in peace, Nutty Wayne and Rick Rock. Four of us is still ticking and kicking. Three main rappers, me, C Night, and Bo Rock.
Okay.
And shout out to P Lo.
And P Lo.
Okay.
Having a six member group.
It was cool. Like, everybody didn't rap per se. Yeah. It was just six of us at our circle. Like,
and we wasn't really like a group. Like, we was more friends than family. Like,
right.
Than anything. That's why we still together today. You know what I'm saying?
That's cool. Not like, you know. Collectors like that, like, where y'all family, like, it's family orientated, like, that type of shit, like, always lasts long, you know?
Yeah.
It's more different from a group, because groups break up.
Yeah.
But, like, family, you know, that's different, you know?
We ain't never had no money issues with each other, okay, that part, too.
His dad is my dad. Like, it's all good. Like, I didn't come out of his sack, but, you know what I'm saying? That's pops. Like, Our family
his
shit
mama,
is like
his mama was my mama.
Yeah, sure. Our shit is real for real.
Show that. We ain't never had that.
It'll present itself if you like, if you weak minded or like not solid as y'all claim to be, it will fall apart. You know what I'm saying? But for us, what don't kill us make us stronger. You know what I'm saying? We done been through some shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. From roller coaster shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? One minute you up high as fuck and then come on down and then take a loop with it and then, you know what I'm saying? Like straight roller coaster shit. But we surviving. We still here.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
Do y'all thing, yeah.
Right.
Absolutely. I seen the movie too.
Yeah. I mean, if you could imagine, like, if they wouldn't have let that affect them and they would have just kept on going, like, the machine would have been.
Same with NWA.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. Definitely, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know y'all came up during that time, you know what I'm saying? Like the Eazy-E days, you know, NWA era.
Yes, sir.
Bro era, you know.
Yes, sir.
Like, what was y'all, like, favorite era? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, the 90s, 80s?
Of course, you just.
I said the 90s.
Of course. It's the 90s. I mean, Warren G album came out in 94. Our album came out in 95.
Okay.
94, 95, 96. You couldn't tell me shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Right. It changed my life. I made moms proud. Like, everything. Everything that was, you know, everybody seen negative.
First time hearing your music on the radio and shit.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's a good feeling. Even like watching y'all video on TV or something.
It was on the box.
The box.
I think it was number one for about 4 weeks.
Our song Summertime in LBC was in rotation so strong. Like, it was played even once or twice every hour on the hour. Like,
we was getting at least 100 plays around the country on every radio station.
Wow.
Even the radio station that didn't play rap.
In the wintertime.
Even in the wintertime.
When it ain't summertime.
Hey, what it was like doing that video, you know what I'm saying? Especially with the, you know what I'm saying, RP, you know, Ricky Harris, you know.
Rest in peace,
shout
Ricky.
Out to Rick.
At the time, he was actually managing us.
Wow, okay.
And, you know, his wife really was like, our manager, our liaison, because, you know, he had a career of his own.
Okay.
But at the same time, he still, you know, pushed and did anything he can do for our group.
Okay.
Man, but his wife, she, like, had us our itineraries for the week or whatever. She kept everything together. The famous, infamous D. Barnes, yeah.
Oh, wow, D. Barnes? Okay. That's legendary right there, man.
Yes, sir.
Definitely, you know what I'm saying, like, you know, enjoy, like, you know, even like telling, like, you know, the legends, like, you know, thank you for the classics and everything, because, you know, like, without y'all, you know, contributions, you know, we wouldn't be here doing our thing. So, like, I definitely thank y'all for, you know, for y'all contributions and hip-hop.
Absolutely. And you guys are definitely appreciated. You know what I'm saying? Hip-hop originals. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, definitely appreciated. Stay with it, though.
Yeah, for sure.
Stay with that, you know, stay with your thing.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it. You mentioned some, you know, some new shit. Y'all got anything coming up?
Our new album is called
Parties in Hard Times.
Parties in Hard Times.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just basic example of what's good and what's bad in life. You know what I'm saying? Like, when on Monday you might be on top of the world, by Wednesday is everything's going to hell. You know what I'm saying? Like, parties in hard times. You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's a dope concept.
Yes, sir.
Y'all gonna get a couple of new joints from that project tonight. So
I think it's our best work ever.
Yeah. Wow.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Y'all got a release date?
No release date.
No release date,
Okay.
Be on the lookout for the release date. All
right. You'll know when we drop it.
We're gonna hear tonight a little bit.
Any
advice for new upcoming artists? Make sure you do your paperwork.
Read your paperwork.
Yeah. I think it's super, super easy for artists these days.
We
didn't have the www.internet, you know what I'm saying? But that World Wide Web is the World Wide Web, and you know what I'm saying?
It was kind of hard back in the day to get to every swap meet with a trunk full of tapes. it was kind of hard to do that, you know, back in the day. So you guys got it a lot motherfucking easier.
But that,
you know what I'm saying?
The internet do it for you.
That internet is a platform that, you know, that's undeniable, you know what I'm saying? And they can reach the masses, and you don't got to wait for nobody. You don't got to wait for a record company to sign you.
Right.
You don't got to wait for nobody to
sign
take you tight.
Self.
If you believe in yourself, you can put yourself out there.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? So.
I hear himself.
Yeah, no, that's real shit right there. Definitely, though, you know what I'm saying? Y'all got, like, you know, social media or a website, anybody can find y'all at?
Well, you can find me at Dove_Shaq_20.
Okay.
Kurt Big Nuts on Facebook.
I'm Scoop Brown on Facebook, and I'm Scooped Up ENT on everything else.
Okay.
On everything else, Twitter, everything.
All right, for sure. Hey, real quick question too. You know what I'm saying? Long Beach question. Like, how you feel about Snoop acquiring Death Row again?
I congratulate him. I think it was a grown ass man move.
My first thoughts of it was like, I didn't think much of it because I thought like he had a record label already, like with Doggy Style Records, and he had the same resources. It was probably gonna do the same thing, but he proved me wrong because he ahead of the game with his meta.
NFC, Zach Tomundo. Right.
And he killing them. He took all this shit off of all the normal platforms and all that shit.
Yeah.
iTunes and all that, you can't get it.
Yeah.
Now you gotta go through him and his shit.
Right.
And, brilliant. That's fucking the genius.
Yeah,
and
that's a
beat boss move.
I congratulate him. Like I said, I congratulate him. Shout out to Snoop.
Shout out to Snoop.
Hey, you already know, man. Hey, shout out to Snoop, you know what I'm saying? The Dub Shack, the LBC, you know what I'm saying? Summertime, you already know what it is. Hey, this is like the best time, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit, summertime.
Yeah.
Shout out to the rest of the Dub Shack. Nita P, we still love you. You already know that, girl.
Oh, yeah.
Shout out to Bo Rock. You know, he ain't here yet.
He'll be here in a few minutes.
Yeah, he on his way and whatnot.
He got a video today.
Shout out to P Lo.
Yeah, he in Vegas.
Okay.
And, shout out to Young Dub Shack.
Okay.
Luminati.
Scoop Fetty.
Hey,
my little brother. Today, my brother's birthday. He's going to open up for us.
Okay, happy birthday to him.
Yes, happy birthday.
Definitely, you know what I'm saying? We're going to rock out, you know what I'm saying? Y'all going to hit the stage in a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Smoke one real quick, you know what I'm saying?
Man,
no, not
time.
One. We ain't smoking one real quick.
Be on the lookout.
Yeah.
Right, 8 o'clock?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
we're going to get some of the footage on that, too. But
oh, yeah, please do.
Shout out to the other artists that's here, too, and shit, too.
Oh, yeah.
Shout out to Hip Hop Originals.
Yeah,
definitely.
Shout out to Hip Hop Originals.
Hey, definitely, you know what I'm saying? Thank y'all for, like, stopping by and everything. Like, I really appreciate this shit for real.
Tanada.
You already know. We're going to end it right there. Hey, Hip Hop Originals, man. Y'all stay tuned. We out.
Yeah.
Peace.
West.
How looking, man?
Appreciate it.
Yeah. This is C-Night from the Dove Shack. Getting dough shit out, kicking it at King's Park with all the homies. You know what I'm saying? So what you check out my homie Bo to the Rock.
I ride with the, I slide with the lows and dogs from the LBC. All of the hoes wanna kick it with me, cause I run with Warren G. Weed busters and G. Water bloom fighters, low riders, and east side.